It was in the middle of COVID. My girlfriend at the time, her mom had a cat, a feral cat that was she was feeding. I took the cat in. My girlfriend was like, "Hey, you're at home not doing anything. You're just playing World of Warcraft and making music all day. Why don't you, maybe it's time to get a cat." I named her Maladath. It was actually, she was named after a sword in World of Warcraft. She starts getting bigger. One of my roommates, I go to her. "Are you feeding the cat late at night or something? Like, she's getting big. I don't know what you're talking about. Why would I feed your fucking cat?" And then all of a sudden I was like, "Huh, she's pregnant." And it wasn't like she was overweight. She was getting like, "I'm about to spawn. Life is happening here." It's that like boiling heathen, blah, 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 blah. That is life replicating. Just about 3 years ago, about 6 a.m. on Mother's Day, I woke up and I felt my feet were warm.
Oh God, we have an alien in here.
Felt that heat at the foot of my bed. We knew she was going into labor. A mother cat in labor is a very special thing. They become tender, affectionate, raging with all the hormones that every mother has ever had. A sacred ritual is taking place and they're just feeling it. Like they're doing exactly what they're supposed to, make more. Take the atoms from all the different corners of this universe that have all gone on this wild fucking journey. 13 and a half billion years, maybe much longer now that if you go on YouTube. And here it is, the repurposing of matter, the repurposing of atoms, finding their own arrangement, opening their own eyes, thrust into the world next to the warmth of their furry ass mother. It's powerful. She gave birth to 7 kittens. I awoke when kitten number 7 was coming out. And the little sample from the end, the purring, probably a week after they were born, the purr of a mother cat with her kittens, it's like it comes from the belly of the earth. You just hear it. It's like life, a little critter that's happy. And thus I think the highest honor that one can ever aspire to in this cold and unforgiving world of ours is if you've been able to give the comfort and happiness and security to a critter, you at least did one thing right.